during the final night of former President Ramos's wake, one of his grandsons called on the Filipino people to fight and keep his legacy alive. Those who are dear to him are bravely heeding that call. Michelle Long reports.
It was one of the most iconic moments of the 1986 EDSA Revolution, and one that will eventually define the legacy of former President Fidel V. Ramos, a legacy and an important part of Philippine history, which one of his grandsons fears is under attack.
The history of EDSA has sadly become a matter of the present culture war debate. In those politicized narratives, we often lose sight of simpler unifying truths. That the EDSA revolution was bloodless in it of itself can be thought of as a miracle. That the AFP did not fracture, that this country was spared a potential civil war before, during, and after EDSA is one of FVR's greatest, most enduring, and perhaps underappreciated legacies.
But those whose lives were touched by FVR vowed to keep that memory alive.
In 1987, after I think the 1987 coup, he gathered his commanders, his key commanders, and basically told them, we are going to hold the line. We're going to make sure that we defend democracy and freedom, which we fought hard for.
We had just said goodbye to President Cory, and this was now President Fidel V. Ramos. So the task at hand was what? Was to be able to say to our people that it was worth the EDSA revolution. It was already institutionalizing the foundations of a good democracy.
He did it by action. He defended democracy. He respected constitutional processes. Walang mga pinakulong na mga media, wala siyang binan sa palasyo, wala siyang pinasarang mga newspapers, walang ad boycott. So for that alone, I guess it speaks more than any word can describe this.
For his family, while the former president wore many hats, they want him to be remembered as someone who will inspire Filipinos to continue the fight and continue protecting our hard-fought democracy.
Fidel V. Ramos was many things to many people. A son, a brother, a soldier, a scuba diver, a loving husband and father, a warrior in battle, and a golfing buddy. By his life, FVR has set the ultimate example. But for all of his astonishing achievements, let us remember, FVR was just a man, a person, a human being, as are we all. Mortal, yes, even flawed perhaps, and yet just as capable of the same heroic acts and almost boundless achievement. He was the best of us. But if I've learned one thing from him, above all else, it is that the best is in us all. Now it is time for this old soldier's well-deserved rest. He fought the good fight. He has finished his work. But we have not. I saw that one eminent historian referred to FVR's passing as the passing of a generation. Let us instead think of it as the passing of the torch.
A marching order in honor of an exceptional man. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.
For former Finance Secretary Roberto de Ocampo, the late former President Ramos truly embodied his nickname, Steady Eddie. De Ocampo says Ramos was never one to panic, even when the Asian financial crisis of the 90s hit the Philippines.
Both of us, and I have to include in the team facing that Asian crisis, the late Gabby Singson, who was also very close to FVR, all of us, we're not the types to press the panic button and start panicking the rest of the public. Instead, we looked at it as calmly as we could, and decide from what were the parameters to be addressed, what action steps to take in a steady eddy manner. Mm-hmm. You don't just suddenly press the panic button and put in draconian measures when they are not necessary.